लिसनिंग रेडियो कांची 90.4 FM, हम सबका रेडियो। आई एम डॉक्टर राजीव अस्थाना, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, गौसन कॉलेज, रांची। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस बोस आइंस्टीन स्टैटिस्टिक्स फॉर फिजिक्स ऑनर्स बीएससी स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सिक्स सेमेस्टर, रांची यूनिवर्सिटी। बोस आइंस्टीन स्टैटिस्टिक्स इज अ प्रोसीड्यूर फॉर काउंटिंग द पॉसिबल स्टेट्स ऑफ क्वांटम सिस्टम्स composed of identical particles with integer spin. It takes its name from S. N. Bose, the Indian physicist who first proposed it for light quanta in 1924, and Albert Einstein, who extended it to gas molecules in 1924-25. Bose-Einstein's statistics is applicable to the particles which are identical, indistinguishable, having integral spin. That is total spin angular momentum measured in units of h cross, and symmetrical wave functions, that is, it remains unchanged under interchange of any two particles, means interchange of both their spatial and spin coordinates. These particles are called bosons. Examples are photons, He4 atoms, etc. For an example, consider a gas of only two particles A and B. We assume that each particle can be in one of the three possible quantum states represented by S is equal to 1, 2 and 3. Now let us see that in how many distinct ways one can put particles A and B into three single particle state labeled 1, 2 and 3. In Bose-Einstein statistics, the particles are indistinguishable, hence B equals to A, and any number of particles can be in any one state. So the ways to arrange them is shown in the figure below. The first way is to put the both particles AA in the first state. The second way is to put AA in the second state. The third way is to put both AA in third state. Now, the fourth way is to put A in the first state and the second A in the second state. The fifth way is to put first A in the first state and the second A in the third state. And the sixth way is to put the first A in the second state and the second A in the third state. So we find that there are three different ways of placing the particles in the same state, and there are three distinct ways of placing the particles in different states. Hence, there exists a total of 3 plus 3 is equal to 6 possible states for the whole gas. If we define a quantity, xi is equal to probability that the two particles are found in the same state divided by probability that the two particles are found in different states. Then, in the BE statistics, we will get xi is equal to 1. For MB statistics, it will be 1 by 2. And for FD statistics, it will be equal to 0. Thus, in the BE case, there is a greater relative tendency for particles to bunch together in the same state than in the classical statistics. On the other hand, in the FD case, there is a greater relative tendency for the particles to remain apart in different states than there is in the classical statistics. Now we go into the derivation of Bose-Einstein distribution law. We consider a gas in a volume V in equilibrium at temperature T. Let the symbol small r or small s to be used to denote the possible quantum state of a single particle. Epsilon r represents energy of a particle in state r. Small n r represents number of particles in state r. Capital R represents the possible quantum states of the whole gas. If we assume that there is negligible interaction between the molecules of the gas, then total energy of the gas in state r, where there are n1 particles in state r, is equal to 1. And two particles in state R is equal to 2 is written as capital ER is equal to N1 epsilon 1 plus N2 epsilon 2 plus N3 epsilon 3 and so on. That equals summation NR epsilon R, equation 1, where the sum extends over all the possible states R of the particle. If the total number of particles in the gas are known to be capital N, then we will have summation small nr is equal to capital N. This represents equation 2. In order to calculate the thermodynamic functions of the gas, it is necessary to calculate the partition function, which is written as Z is equal to summation of e to the power minus beta capital ER summation over capital R is equal to summation e to the power minus beta multiplied by within bracket N1 epsilon 1 plus N2 epsilon 2 plus N3 epsilon 3 plus so on. This represents equation 3. Here the sum is over all the possible states capital R of the gas, that is essentially over all the possible values of the numbers N1, N2, N3, etc. The term e to the power minus beta within bracket N1 epsilon 1 plus N2 epsilon 2 and so on is the relative probability of finding the gas in a particular state where there are N1 particles in state 1, N2 particles in state 2 and so on. Hence the average number of particles in state S will be written as NS bar is equal to summation NS e to the power minus beta within bracket N1 epsilon 1 plus N2 epsilon 2 plus so on total divided by summation e to the power minus beta within bracket N1 epsilon 1 plus N2 epsilon 2 plus so on, bracket closed. This will represent our equation 4. Or we can write Ns bar is equal to 1 upon Z summation of minus 1 by beta del over del epsilon S e to the power minus beta within bracket N1 epsilon 1 plus N2 epsilon 2 plus so on. That will equal to 1 upon beta Z del Z over del epsilon S. So Ns bar is equal to minus 1 by beta del over del epsilon S of log Z. This will represent equation 5. Hence the mean number of particles in a single particle state S can be expressed in the terms of partition function Z. Now the sum over all possible states capital R of the gas can be understood as follows. In Bose-Einstein statistics, particles are indistinguishable, so by just specifying the numbers N1, N2 and so on is enough to specify the state of the gas. Thus it is necessary only to sum over all possible numbers of particles in each single particle state, that is over possible values nr is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on for each small r. If the total number of particles is fixed, these numbers must satisfy the restriction summation nr is equal to capital N. Now the equation 4 can be written as ns bar is equal to summation ns e to the power minus beta within bracket n1 epsilon 1 plus n2 epsilon 2 and so on divided by summation e to the power minus beta within bracket n1 epsilon 1 plus n2 epsilon 2 plus n3 epsilon 3 and so on. This represents equation 6. By summing first over all possible values of ns using the multiplicative property of the exponential function and rearranging the order of summation, equation 6 can be written as ns bar is equal to summation ns e to the power minus beta ns epsilon s, summation is done for all ns, then multiplied by summation e to the power minus beta within bracket n1 epsilon 1 plus n2 epsilon 2 plus n3 epsilon 3 and so on. Summation is done for all n1, n2, etc. And in the superscript, we have shown in within bracket S. This total divided by summation e to the power minus beta ns epsilon s into summation e to the power minus beta within bracket n1 epsilon 1 plus n2 epsilon 2 and so on. This represents equation 7. In the above expression, the last sums in the numerator and denominator omit from consideration the particular state S This is shown by the superscript S on the summation symbol. The sums in equation 7 range over all values of n1, n2 and so on, such that nr is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. for each r. But these numbers must always satisfy the restriction summation nr is equal to capital N. Performing explicitly the sum over ns, the equation 7 becomes ns bar is equal to 0 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon s zs n minus 1 plus 2 e to the power minus 2 beta epsilon s zs n minus 2 plus so on, divided by zs n plus e to the power minus beta epsilon s zs n minus 1 plus e to the power minus 2 beta epsilon s zs n minus 2 plus so on. This is our equation 8, where zs n is equal to summation of e to the power minus beta bracket n1 epsilon 1 plus n2 epsilon 2 plus so on, which represents the sum extended over all states except s. If capital N particles are to be distributed over these remaining states, that is, if summation nr is equal to capital N, state s omitted from the sum, then we will get for delta n far less than n, log zs n minus delta n is equal to log zs n minus del log zs over del n into delta n is equal to log zs n minus alpha s delta n. Or we can write zs n minus delta n is equal to zs n e to power minus alpha s n, where alpha s is equal to del of log zs over del n, equation 10. But since zsn is a sum over many states, we can expect that the variation of its logarithm with n should be very insensitive as to which particular state s has been omitted from this sum. So we introduce the approximation that alpha s is independent of s. Hence we can write alpha s is equal to alpha for all s. Equation 11. Therefore alpha is equal to del of log z over del n. Equation 12. Using equation 9 and equation 11, the result 8 becomes ns is equal to zsn into bracketed term 0 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon s e to the power minus alpha plus 2 e to the power minus 2 beta epsilon s into e to the power minus 2 alpha plus so on, bracket closed, divided by zsn bracket start 1 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon s into e to the power minus alpha plus e to the power minus 2 beta epsilon s e to the power minus 2 alpha plus so on, bracket closed. Or ns bar is equal to summation ns e to the power minus ns into alpha plus beta epsilon s divided by summation e to the power minus ns into alpha plus beta epsilon s, equation number 13. Or ns bar is equal to minus 1 over beta into del over del epsilon s of summation e to the power minus ns into alpha plus beta epsilon s total divided by summation e to the power minus ns into alpha plus beta epsilon s. This equals to minus 1 upon beta del over del epsilon of log summation e to the power minus ns into alpha plus beta epsilon s. This is equation 14. But summation of e to the power minus ns into alpha plus beta epsilon s is equal to 1 plus e to the power minus alpha plus beta epsilon s plus e to the power minus 2 into alpha plus beta epsilon s plus so on, and this will be equal to 1 upon 1 minus e to the power minus bracket mein alpha plus beta epsilon s. Hence equation 14 becomes ns bar is equal to 1 upon beta del over del epsilon s log of 1 minus e to the power minus alpha plus beta epsilon s. This becomes equal to 1 upon e to the power alpha plus beta epsilon s minus 1. Hence ns bar equals 1 upon e to the power alpha plus beta epsilon s minus 1. This represents equation 15, which is our final expression and is known as Bose-Einstein distribution formula. In this slide we are showing the graph representing Bose-Einstein, Maxwell-Boltzmann and Fermi-Dirac statistics. रेड वन इज फॉर बोस आइंस्टीन, ब्लू रिप्रेजेंट्स फॉर मैक्सवेल बोल्ट्जमैन एंड ग्रीन रिप्रेजेंट्स फॉर फर्मी डिराक। So here I conclude my lecture on Bose-Einstein statistics. Thanks for listening. Thank you very much.